हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पी के वर्मा, इन कंटिन्यूएंस विथ द एनिमल किंगडम, टुडे आई शैल डिस्कस द सुपर फाइलम एस्केलेमिन्थेस, दैट इज ए फाइलम ऑफ स्यूडो सिलोवेट एनिमल्स. It is a large phylum with great diversity of habit and habitat, structures and the life cycle, and therefore it has been regarded as a super phylum rather than a phylum. And as many as five phyla have been included in Aeschylminthes. Gaggenbauer in 1851 at first used the name Nemathelminthes, but Graben in 1910 used the name Aeschylminthes for the roundworms. It is a group of many parasitic as well as free living worms with great variations in anatomy and life cycle. So many scientists prefer to regard this group as a superphylum. The class Nematoda is, however, its major division. Now let us see some of the general characters found in the roundworms. These worms have cylindrical shape, although the common name is roundworm. So round is its cross section, but because of the length it is a cylindrical worm. And the common name roundworm is against the flatworms. These are triploblastic animals with better developed mesoderm forming a body cavity known as pseudocoelom. Most scientists believe that this pseudocoelom is the remains of blastocoel. It has no mesodermal epithelial lining and therefore not a true coelom. Its body is unsegmented. Epidermis forms syncytium by fusion of cells. A true pellicle is not found. The so-called pellicle is in fact the syncytial epidermal cells that contains endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, etc. The elementary canal is well developed and straight from mouth to anus. But the digestive glands are lacking in most of them. The circulatory and respiratory systems are still absent. The intestinal parasites like Ascaris and Ancylostoma have anaerobic respiration, but others living in blood, lymph, or freely in water may absorb oxygen from the general body surface or its tegument. They have an excretory system made of 4 or 5 Raynaud cells. These cells fuse to form a H-shaped structure that opens ventrally just behind mouth. They have no head and sense organs, though there is a nervous system made of ganglia and nerve cords. They have primary sense cells forming cilia, tetrapods, papillae, and amphids. In some free-living worms, eye spots also have been reported, but these are photoreceptors and do not form the image. The animals are unisexual or dioecious. The males are shorter than females in length, and there may be morphological difference between male and female. So they have a sexual dimorphism. The male has a single tubular testis in which sperms are formed only in its terminal part, and the rest part acts as a sperm duct. The females have a pair of tubular ovaries. The gametes are formed only in the terminal part, and the rest part act as oviduct. The two oviducts fuse together to form a common uterus and vagina, opening outwards as a single genital aperture. At the terminal end of testis or ovaries, there is a rachis around which germinal epithelium is present and forms the sperms or ova. Such animals are known as telogonic. The sperms are tailless and amoeboid, whereas ova contain sufficient yolk or lecithin to supply nutrition for embryonic development. The female worms of most species secrete a protective shell around the ova, and they lay large number of eggs, but Filaria worm produces larvae, so it is ovoviviparous. The life cycle of parasitic forms of class Nematoda is more complicated and may involve one or two hosts. There are five separate groups of pseudocoelomate roundworms, and they have the status of phylum. These are rotifers, gastrotrycha, Kynorhynchia, Nematomorpha, and Nematoda. So let us take one after another. The rotifers are microscopic aquatic animals found in many freshwater environments and in the moist soil, where they inhabit the thin films of water that are formed around soil particles. They are microscopic. Most species of rotifers are about 200 to 500 micrometer in length. However, a few species, such as Rotaria neptunia, may be longer than a millimeter. The name rotifer is derived from the Latin word meaning wheel bearer, due to the crown of cilia around the mouth of the rotifer. The general body plan of rotifer consists of four basic regions: head, neck, trunk, and the foot. The body of rotifer is externally but not internally segmented. The external segmentation is a false segmentation. The body with a semi-permeable, extendable, and transparent cuticle. Foot contains a cement gland with which the rotifer may attach themselves to objects in the water and shift food at its leisure. The diet of rotifers most commonly consists of dead or decomposing organic materials as well as unicellular algae and other phytoplanktons. The food is ground by a trophy. These trophy are jaw-like structures located just behind the mouth in the pharynx. It is characteristic feature of all the rotifers. Some species consist only of female that produce their daughters by unfertilized eggs. It is a type of reproduction known as parthenogenesis. The eggs are released and hatched in water in which there is external development. But other subspecies have two types of eggs that develop by parthenogenesis. One type of egg forms the female and the other type develops into degenerate male that cannot even feed but help in sexual reproduction. It is called cyclic parthenogenesis. That is, the male and females are produced by parthenogenesis, and after fertilization, another diploid female is formed. So it is a sexual reproduction. So sexual and parthenogenesis alternate one another. The common examples are Conochilus, Synantheria, Erineta, Lipadelia, etc. Now see a common rotifer found in local ponds in large numbers as planktons or the zooplanktons. They become food of higher trophic level that are secondary consumers. Phylum 2 is Gastrotrichia. These are commonly referred to as hairy bellies or their hairy backs. This group also is microscopic with a size 0.06 millimeter to 3 millimeter. These are worm-like pseudocoelomate animals. And these are widely distributed in abundance in freshwater and marine environment both. They are mostly benthic and live within the periphyton, the layer of tiny organisms and detritus that is found on the bed of pond, lakes, rivers, ocean, etc. Nearly 800 species of Gastrotrichia have been described. They have a simple body plan with a head region containing a brain and sensory organs, a trunk with a simple gut and reproductive organ. Because of the brain and sensory organ, they seem to be more developed than the parasitic worms. They have adhesive gland with which they can anchor themselves to the substrate and cilia with which they move around. They feed on detritus, sucking up organic particles with their muscular pharynx. They are hermaphrodite. The marine species produce eggs which develop directly into miniature adults, that is, larval stage is absent, but the freshwater species are parthenogenetic. Gastrotrichs mature with great rapidity and have lifespan of only a few days. The common examples are मैक्रोडिसीटा, टाइकोस्टोमेला एटसेट्रा। नाउ सी द फोटोग्राफ ऑफ दिस मैक्रोडिसीटा। दिस इज ए लेवल डायग्राम ऑफ द सेम। हेयर यू कैन सी द माउथ इज एट एंटेरियर एंड एंड देयर इज ए लार्ज पार्ट फॉर्मिंग द ब्रेन। एलिमेंट्री कैनाल इज वेल डेवलप्ड एंड टर्मिनेट्स एज एनस ऑन द बॉडी सरफेस। नंबर ऑफ स्पाइंस एंड ब्रिसल्स आर प्रेजेंट। नाउ द थर्ड फाइलम इज काइनेटोरिंकिया। द काइनोरिंका इज ए फाइलम ऑफ ए स्मॉल मैरीन इनवर्टिब्रेट्स दैट आर वाइड स्प्रेड इन मड और सैंड एट ऑल डेप्थ। दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मड ड्रैगन। द मॉडर्न स्पेसीज आर 1 millimeter और लेस बट सम एक्सटिंक्ट स्पेसीज वे आर प्रोबेबली लार्जर। दे आर सुपरफिशियली सेगमेंटेड limbless with a body consisting of head, neck and a trunk of 11 segments. So the number of segments, although it is false, is limited. Unlike some similar invertebrates, they do not have external cilia but instead have a number of spines along the body plus up to 7 circles of spines around the head. These spines are used for locomotion, withdrawing the head and pushing forward, then gripping the substrate with the spines while drawing up the body. The body wall consists of thin syncytial layer that secretes a tough cuticle. So in this case, cuticle is tough. This is molted several times while growing to adulthood. The spines are essentially movable extensions of body wall and are hollow and covered by cuticle. The head is completely retractable and is covered by a set of neck plates called placid when retracted. Kynorhynchs eat either diatoms or organic materials found in mud depending on the species. The mouth is located in a conical structure at the apex of head. Pharynx and esophagus both are lined by cuticle. Two pairs of salivary glands and one or more pairs of pancreatic glands connect to the esophagus and secrete digestive enzymes. So again, these are better developed than nematoda that have no definite digestive gland. The midgut combines the function of stomach and intestine. Lack a cuticle enabling it to absorb nutrition. So nutrition is digested and absorbed in the midgut. The short hind gut is lined by cuticle and empties into anus at the posterior end of the trunk. So nothing can be absorbed from the hind gut. There is no circulatory system, although body cavity or pseudocoel is well developed and includes amoebocytes in the body cavity. The excretory system consists of two protonephridia emptying through pores in the final segment. The nervous system consists of a ventral nerve cord and one ganglion in each segment and an anterior nerve ring surrounding the pharynx. The smaller ganglia are also located in the lateral and dorsal part of each segment, but do not form distinct cord. The two sexes look alike. A pair of gonads are located in mid-region of trunk and open to pores in the final segment. In most species, sperm ducts include two or three spiny structures that help in copulation. Individual spermatozoa can reach a quarter of the total body length, so as compared to body, it is larger. The larvae are free living, but little else is known of their reproductive process. After having laid an egg, the female packs it into a protective envelope of mud and organic material. The most common example is echinoderms. Now see a photograph of echinotric echinoderm. You can see the segmented body. Now fourth class is fourth phylum is Nematomorpha. These are commonly known as horsehair worm or the guardian worms. These are superficially similar to nematoda in morphology. Hence this name Nematomorpha is given. Most species range in size from 50 to 100 millimeter, that is 2 to 3.9 inch long, reaching 2 meters in extreme cases and 1 to 3 millimeters in diameter. The horsehair worms can be found in damp area such as watering trough, swimming pools, streams, puddles and cisterns. The adult worms are free living, but the larvae are parasitic on the arthropods. Nematomorphs possess an external cuticle without cilia. Internally, they have only longitudinal muscles and a non-functional gut with no excretory, respiratory or circulatory system. The nervous system consists of a nerve ring near the anterior end of animal and a ventral nerve cord running along the body. Reproductively, they have two distinct sexes with internal fertilization of eggs that are then laid in gelatinous string. The adults have cylindrical gonads opening into cloaca. The larvae have rings of cuticular hooks and terminal stylet that are believed to be used to enter the host. Once inside the host, the larvae live inside the hemocele and absorbs nutrition directly through their skin. Development into adult form takes weeks or months, and the larva molts several times as it grows in size. The common example is spinocordates. See the photograph of a spinocordate. It looks like an insect. See, in fact, the insect is here and the worm is here. This worm is hanging on the feet of the insect. The last and most developed phylum is Nematoda. They are diverse animal phylum inhabiting a broad range of environment. As many as 25,000 species are estimated as per data of 2011. The nematodes are very small, slender worms, typically 5 to 100 micrometer thick and 0.1 to 2.5 millimeter long, but many are longer. The smallest nematodes are microscopic, where free living species can reach up to 5 centimeter, and some parasitic species are larger, reaching up to 1 meter or 3 feet in length. The body is often ornamented with ridges, rings, bristles, or other distinctive structures. Unlike flatworms, they have tubular digestive system with opening at both ends. The mouth has either 6 or 3 lips, which often bear a series of teeth on their inner edge. The adhesive caudal gland is often found at the tip of the tail. The epidermis forms syncytium, or a single layer of cells, and is covered by a thick collagenous cuticle. 4 peripheral nerves run along the length of body, 1 on dorsal, ventral, and 2 lateral surfaces, within a cord of connective tissue lying beneath the cuticle and between the muscle cells. The body of nematodes are covered in numerous sensory bristles and papilla that together provide a sense of touch. Behind the sensory bristles on the head lie 2 small pits or amphids. These are probably chemoreceptor organ. A few aquatic nematodes possess what appears to be pigmented eye spot, but whether or not these are actually sensory in nature is not clear. Most nematode species are dioecious, with separate male and female. Male is smaller than female. Cnidarioidetes elegans is androecious, consisting of hermaphrodites, and male is rare. Both sexes possess tubular gonads. These gonads are telogonic. In male, there is a single testis. Mind it, the male has a single testis, and the sperms are produced at the apex of the duct, migrate along its length. As it matures, these sperms are amoeboid. When fertilization occurs, the complete sperm fuses with ovum. The females have 2 tubular telogonic ovaries, and the oviducts fuse to form uterus. Fertilization is internal in uterus or oviduct. The female may be oviparous or sometimes ovoviviparous. In Ascaris, pinworm, and hookworm, it is oviparous. But in Filaria worm, Bucheraria bancrofti, it is ovoviviparous, that is, gives birth to larva or embryo. Some common nematodes are common roundworm, Ascaris lumbricoides, pinworm or threadworm, Enterobius vermicularis, hookworm, Ancylostoma duodenale, Filaria worm, Bucheraria bancrofti, eye worm, Loa, fiery serpent, or the guinea worm, Dracunculus medinensis. See, these are the female and male Ascaris. Female looks stronger and longer, but the males are thinner and shorter, with a coiled back. If you just make them straight, the posterior end of the male becomes curved. So tail part is curved, having a pair of spicules, and एक्लोएका। दिस इज एनसाइलोस्टोमा डिओडिनल, लिव्स मोस्टली इन डिओडिनम बट इट कैन डिसेंड डाउन इनटू अ स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन एंड कम्स आउट थ्रू फीकस। द मोस्ट नोटोरियस वर्म इज द पिनवर्म एंटेरोबियस वर्मिकुलरिस। इट लिव्स इन अ स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, moves into large intestine up to the anus, and by its pointed tip it inserts its anterior end into the skin, causing a very pitiable condition for the adults, but it is more common in the children. You can see how small it is. The photograph is taken of a child having pinworm coming out through anus. So you have learned the great diversity in roundworms, the pseudocoelomate S. helminthus. Thank you very much.